Ladies and gentlemen, my name is Matt. I am the American Canadian Gamer, and welcome back to Destiny. You might notice that things are just a wee tad little bit different. Namely, my gamer tag is very different, and I'm only level 8. That is because I actually had to make a new Xbox Live account because my old one is very tied to my ex-wife. So I just kind of had to make a new one because they make it a bear to transfer anything, and it was just easier to make a new account and level a guardian up to where I am in the playthrough, which is just finishing up the moon. So I am no longer ahead of the curve. I am at level for everything that we're doing, and I'm not exactly decked out and like geared out and have all of the cool stuff that I had beforehand. I'm basically just a good old level 8 warlock. Nothing special about me. I still haven't decided on a new gamer tag yet. That's the default one that it came with, the Poppy Money, and we'll just see what I can think of down the road. But for now, that's what it's going to be, and it's probably going to be like that for the next few videos, because I am kind of determined just to sit down and record a lot of Destiny right now. So, let's go ahead and set our next destination. We are actually going on the path to Venus and the Ishtar Sink. So, the jungles of Venus can conceal great treasures and terrible power. And our first mission is a stranger's call. We have to follow the stranger's coordinates to a legendary colony lost in the jungles of Venus. The stranger that contacted us in the last episode before we delved into the deepest, darkest parts of the moon. So let's go ahead and get going with it, shall we? Level 10? Hard impossible. So I kind of am supposed to level up in the crucible, I guess. That's okay. I don't need it. I actually probably need it. I probably should be like level 13 and do it on level 10. That'd probably be best for me.
Our new friend must have access to extraordinary methods to have reached out to us like that. The radio message she sent came from somewhere in the jungles of Venus. This colony was built by the Ishtar Collective. Records say they once studied ruins older than humanity itself. We thought this was all lost in the collapse.
Huh, I don't remember that from my last playthrough. Apparently there were ruins on Venus. I don't remember that. Huh. That's pretty neat. So at one point, Venus was inhabitable, at least some kind of species. Then we came back and terraformed it, and we found ruins. That's pretty cool.
I don't like us getting dragged out here and not being able to get the lay of the land. There used to be a guardian outpost nearby. Let's see what they have on this place.
Alright, let's, I guess we'll just make our way there, shall we? Go ahead and unable to summon in this location. Can I not summon on Venus yet? Am I not, like, tied into the grid? Yeah, I'm not able to actually summon a vehicle, am I? Let me get on the road and try one more time. Yeah, I need to patch into the grid so I can do that. Their vehicle summoning grid thingy they have there. Their excuse for not letting us do that. That is a fallen ship. And fallen are everywhere. Like, out of all of the species you come across, the fallen are definitely, like, the main opponents of humanity, it would seem. At least this far into the game. They're the ones that actually are, like, most actively going after humanity, like the Hive and the any other of the other races are more or less just territorial. These ones are actually, like, aggressive. That's a shank, but do we have any shank? Oh, there's dregs right here. Level 10 dregs. Let's take them down. I'm not even close to level 9. I'm barely past level 8. But hopefully this will actually level me up. But, I mean, I could go do some patrol missions, like, and level up a bit as well. Like, they definitely expected you to not be ready for this. Obviously, they wanted you to grind a little bit, it seemed, or they expected you to do some actual competitive multiplayer. They didn't scale it up for just, like, a story playthrough. These guys should be, like, level 9. That, or I maybe just should have fought a little harder when I did my playthroughs and killed more people. At least I'm getting plenty of target practice. I will be a good shot with a controller eventually. I said eventually, not yet. I mean, you can see how bad I'm missing. I ain't good yet. I will be. I hope. Eventually, possibly. Probably not, but I'm hoping. Alright, which way do I need to go? Am I still going that way? Yeah, there's a glowing thing over here. What do we have over here? Isn't this the Spirit Bloom? Yeah, that is the resource collectible on Venus. And we have some guys over here. Can I one-shot you? Yes, I can. Do you have buddies? Yeah, you have a couple buddies. Do you have anything I want to just finish with a sniper rifle? Anybody bigger than a drag? Yeah, there's a Vandal. And I miss, because I'm bad. There we go. Alright, now let's get in there. These dregs I'm not too concerned about. Even at level 10, they are really, like, not a challenge at all. Of course I can't jump, because, you know, I kind of forget that there's this jetpack that I have. What were you thinking? Like, I don't know. Maybe he's specced for melee combat, too. Take the Spirit Bloom. And what do we have here? Is this the grid? So I can summon a vehicle now? This was the Guardian Outpost, wasn't it?
We're linked. Sparrow is accessible.
That's exactly what it was.
War machines called the Vex. Indestructible, relentless, supremely intelligent. And they can teleport. Great. Guardians used to have sensors to track them. Let's get them back online.
Oh yeah, the Vex. I forgot all about those little guys. It's gonna be fun to come across. Let's check out these cars for a second. There's a dead ghost in this one. And of course it gives Grimoire card progress. Go to Bungie.net to see your progress. Yep, you couldn't put that stuff in game for us to check out. That is probably my most major complaint about this game. Is they didn't have any kind of, like, real in-game codex for that stuff. Right, we have a Vandal and some dregs. The Vandal will pop his head up a little more. I should be able to pick him off. There's another Vandal. Vandal Savage. There we go. Oh, the Vandal Savage is immortal, so we're going to see him again. These dregs, on the other hand, are a little bit more expendable. And I am almost out of primary ammo. That is not good, because I desperately am going to be needing plenty of it. Well, I just picked up a little fair bit, so I have a couple spare mags on me. This guy didn't seem to drop any. I don't see any more laying around. That's wonderful. You, on the other hand, let's take a gander at this statue. That is really neat. Oh, on the one side you have the DNA double helix, and on the other you have like a reef or leaf thing. I don't know what this is called on this side. If somebody knows in the comments, let me know. But that's kind of neat. So is that like a balance between science and nature at that point, is what you're believing? Or maybe since that's an angel, like science and, you know, just spirituality? That's neat. That's really neat. I can identify with that a little bit. I like that this tree stump is glowing. Let's go check out this tree stump, because the others aren't glowing like this one. Does that mean there's... Oh, it's just the light coming out of that water. No, no, it's actually the light coming out of this thing. Okay, I thought maybe there was something special about this. Or maybe there is. And maybe there's not. Well, that's a shame. I was hoping, like, maybe there was something hidden inside of it, but there's no way to get inside of it. Vandal and Servitor. Let's chuck a nade in there with them. Maybe that'll take out some of them a little bit. Didn't get any XP, so I didn't get a kill. No heavy ammo. Alright, let's reload. Servitor's almost down, just a couple more rounds to the center of his face, and he's gone. Oh, it's actually just one more round. That's nice. Then this drag. Then this drag too. These both can be meleeed. Excuse me. I think I inhaled something when I was talking there. Alright, fully reloaded there. Let's reload that. I still have no heavy ammo, which might come up as a problem later on. I know this is not the direction I'm supposed to be going, but it's still a direction. Not much of a direction. I mean, it's kind of a dead end, but I got to check it out. It was a thing. Alright, is this to open this door, I'm assuming? I don't remember Venus. Like, at all. I don't remember anything here.
These sensors are extensive. Okay, I should be able to track these machines. Let's head to those coordinates and find out what she wants us to see.
Oh, okay. So now we can track the Vex. Okay, that was not to open doors. Okay. Sounds good to me. So now we aren't going to get ambushed too bad by them, I'm assuming. They can't, like, it's kind of like the Darkspawn in Dragon Age Origins when you're a Grey Warden. You know when they're coming, but, you know, like, they're not going to ambush you, but they're still a threat, I guess, is the way that I'm, the thing I'm trying to, ooh, that's nice. All those little effects I never noticed before. More fallen have returned. Is there a vandal? Oh, yep, he saw me too. It was the last thing he saw. I'm really glad I have that sniper rifle because it makes taking care of those guys pretty easy. Maybe these guys should be like level 10. If they were level 9, they would be a little too easy to take down. Just a wee tad bit. Okay, that's fully reloaded. Where am I going? Right in here, okay. As the objective marker on the mini-map is actually pointing this direction, let's check this out up here. And this. I don't see nothing. Alright, let's get in here. Obviously, I'm supposed to go down there, which means I want to check out other stuff first. And there's nothing. I'm surprised they didn't hide more. Like, in little places here, and at least some ammo or something. Something to make it worthwhile, like a med kit, even though we don't really use those. Would have been nice. Like, a dead ghost could have been right here, you know? So, is that a golden? That's a golden chest. I'm still not sure if I want to make my golden chest, like, location videos, so I'm going to leave that one there for now. I'll come back for it. I'm going to leave it there for now, though. Because if I want to do that video, I'm going to have to get footage of it.
Detecting Vex. Like we're surrounded.
If we're surrounded by the time you're detecting the Vex, why didn't you detect them before we were surrounded? I mean, just saying, like, if we're in the middle of them, shouldn't you have detected them when we were on, like, the edge of them? Here.
What is it? Let me get a closer look.
Scan the conflux. Let's do it. Yeah, I can maybe get up here and have better cover. Let's do it. Vex goblins! Actually, up here was a bad idea, because I don't really have a good angle to shoot them with. Although, they're not very smart, are they? I liked how they were still shooting up there, although, does that mean that their AI is actually really smart? Like, the video game AI? Because that made them think I was up there, and it's just like, not sure. At least these guys don't have, like, homing rounds like the Fallen do. Because these many guys with homing rounds would just be way too much for anybody to handle. I'm going to go out on a limb and assume that there's going to be more, if I remember this area correctly. Probably a safe bet, wouldn't you think? Alright, better back up off of this. A hobgoblin! Ow! Okay! Headshots are only mildly useful against you guys. Another hobgoblin. Ow! Oh, a minotaur! Yeah, we should probably get off of this. I remember those guys being big, bad, and hard to take down. Let's just kind of bottleneck them into some areas and pick them off little by little. And then we can take off and get into a better position than this. Would you stop? You are just aggressive with a big gun. Not a good combination for me. That is loot. I will take that. And hopefully get away from that minotaur. And they're immune when they're crouched down like that. I'll have to remember that. Alright, hobgoblin down. Where is that minotaur? Where'd he run off to? Because I have a pretty big gun waiting for him. Wherever he went. Did you really have to sidestep that? Was that completely necessary? I think I can just finish you off just with regular shots now. Don't really need that. What is this? That is nothing. Vex up there, Vex down here. Vex everywhere. Is there Vex over here? No, there's no Vex over here, which means this is probably the best direction for me to take and probably get away from these guys as well. There we go. Alright, let's reload, let those Vex chase me up here. I didn't see any Minotaurs in this group. Yeah, it looks like it's just Goblins and Hobgoblins for this one. Let's make a run for it. Ooh, what's back here? Oh, more stairs. Oh, wasn't I here earlier? Yeah, I was right here earlier. Let's flank them. I didn't think he would actually be turned around based on the AI that I've seen from them previously, but he was ready for me. Man, they pack a little bit of a punch too, don't they? And these last two will be nothing to take care of. Alright. How much longer must this chaos endure? Well, apparently quite a bit longer. There's a piece of green loot. Don't let me forget about that thing. There's another piece of green loot. Ow! Green loot over there. Wait, did he just kind of do like the Warlock punch? I wonder if like the Guardians are kind of based off the various races that you come across in a little bit. Like, are the Hunters kind of like the Fallen in a way, or the Hive in any way, or in the Warlocks kind of like the Vex a bit in the way that they wield the light and, or just the way they behave, because he just kind of did that Warlock punch. It just makes me think, like, I have no evidence, and I'm probably very wrong, but it's just a thought, just the way, like, you know, you gotta ask the questions. If you don't ask questions, you don't get answers. Plain and simple. Oh, I'm out of ammo. Well, there's plenty sitting around, so I should be okay. And I got a scout rifle, it would appear. I still have... Oh, that's a Minotaur. Please tell me there's some ammo just laying around. Don't let me die because I ran out of ammo. Don't let me die because I ran out of ammo! No! I can't go down like this. No, I just can't. I can't. Here's some ammo. Okay. Not dead yet. Not dead yet. 190 rounds altogether for that, so let's take out the snipper rifle. Pick a target and take it down. There's a minotaur behind the statue over here, who's no longer behind the statue. Okay, you should be assault rifleable. Alright, you're down. I think? Yeah, you're down. Now there's just this one minotaur that's left who's down here. Stay away from me! Wow! Okay. That little charge move is a little too aggressive for my taste. It was a bluff! I thought that was the Minotaur! Aw. He's still right around here. That scares me. I need to put some distance between us. Alright, now I should get him. Finally! My word! I thought I was gonna die there when I ran out of assault rifle ammo. Is that all of them? These things.
Are there any still intact that I can analyze?
I think that would be all of them.
Well fought.
You're here.
We haven't got much time.
Who does that voice remind me of?
Who are you?
Why have you been watching us?
I don't even have time to explain why I don't have time to explain. I will. I will. I know.
Will what?
I wasn't talking to you, Little Light.
I'm a ghost, actually.
Many guardians fell. Strong ones. But you made it here. Yes, I'm listening. They are here. With me.
Who's she talking to?
Understood. Help, Guardian.
Is that why you brought us here?
They brought us here. The Vex. Evil so dark it despises other evil.
You're not a Guardian.
No. I was not forged in light. But I believe where our paths cross, ground could break.
It takes a lot of strength to bend metal like that.
Have you heard of the Black Garden?
We've heard the legends.
The greatest threat to us all lies there, where these machines are born. Find the Black Garden. Rip out its heart. Only then will your traveler begin to heal.
Can you help us find it?
My path's my own. I can't.
If we're going to find the Black Garden, we need to see the Awoken.
Ah, yes. The Awoken. Out there wavering between the light and the dark.
Exposition!
A side should always be taken, Little Light. Even if it's the wrong side. Too late, returning. How many? Hold position, kill the engines, and don't let them find you.
So, how do we find the Awoken?
They live all the way out at the edge of the darkness. The last place the light touches.
Can't we just stay here with the murderous robots?
No, little light.
Don't do that.
Some of the storytelling and dialogue in this game is kind of cringeworthy at times, but other times I just find it hilarious. I really do. So we need to go find the Awoken so we can find the Black Garden, which is the source of the Vex, rip out its heart so we stop the Vex altogether. Now, will they go down Phantom Menace style and just all kind of collapse, or will it just be they just can't generate anymore and we can just pick them off one by one and finish them off? Like, is that how it works? Anyways, let's see what we got out of this mission and different gear and everything, and we'll end the video there. So, well, I got a Goblin's Eye. Won't show me what that's for. Let's see here. 40 defense, 32, so I can get rid of that. Slightly better feat. And I mean slightly better feat. Looks cooler, though. I need to get that Engram decoded. And I'll do that between videos. I need to get that decoded as well. 64 attack, 91. Yeah, that scout rifle can go. Snipper rifle. I'll keep the fusion rifle just because, and nothing else. That's all I got. So, next video, next time around, we're going to be heading out to the reef on the asteroid belt. So, as always, ladies and gentlemen, thank you so much for watching. My name is Matt, and I'll see you next time.